So we're here at the FlowHive office, and what we're going to do today is show you how to assemble the Flow Pollinator House. So that's a new product we launched yesterday, and we're really happy to say that it's almost sold out. 100% of the profits are going towards habitat regeneration and protection, so we're pretty excited to be able to support both the little pollinators and also the habitat that the funds will go towards in creating. So here's the pollinator house, and it's made from upcycled FlowHive offcuts. So what I'm going to do is just show you how to put it together, and it's quite simple actually. It's like this. All the parts are laser cut, so they slide together nicely. You will notice that there is blemishes because they're made from the recycled FlowHive pieces. And you'll notice that it sort of has the look of a FlowHive a little bit because we're using the same shingles, and even this is a repurposed cut gabled piece. So you insert the gable like so in the front, and this piece goes on the back. It's a little jigsaw puzzle, but quite easy to put together. Now we've included a little tool. That's a handy little tool for you to keep. The driver bit for the screws also, and you just push that in like so. There's a little screw pack here. Empty out your screws, and then you can simply put the screws through the side like so. Give it a little press, and you can just wind them in by hand. So there's no need to get a drill. So you can see how easy that is to put in. You'll notice on the video, if you haven't seen the video, there's some beautiful shots that my sister Mira has been filming around the world, and it's really nice to see those macro shots of bees. Now I'm just going to keep putting in the screws in the side and just show you how it all fits together. So it's designed to support the solitary bees that don't actually produce honey and don't need a colony, or don't have a colony. And what they do is just nest in little tubes like this. They go in, they lay a few eggs in there, and they rear just a few young, and that's how they procreate and keep going, rather than in a colony. So it's a wonderful thing to be able to support them, because we need pollinators to support the very matrix of life that we all completely depend on. And while honeybees produce an amazing amount of honey, and that's wonderful for us, both for pollination and honey, we also rely on all the native pollinators that are around to do the thing, the magic we call pollination, in order for a lot of the food we eat to grow, in order for a lot of the tree species to grow. So it is important to support these, and it's pollination week here in Australia. So I'm going to keep putting this together now. I might just prop it up so I can easily get to the lower screws. That's the box that the hive comes in, the bamboo tube pieces. And you can see how easy it is to put in these screws. If Joe, you want to come a little closer, it's my nephew behind the camera, you can see how these screws go in. Now push the parts together, and it's a good idea to push the screw a little bit so it just starts to bite into the wood, and then with this tool you simply turn it around like that. You can almost do it with one finger, and in goes the screw. And just bury it to the point where it's just flush with the wood. you go too far, you might start to split it. So I'm going to turn that over now and keep putting in screws. Again, push it down a little bit and wind the screw in. Like so. Keep going around, putting the screws in. If you've got any questions, please put them in the comments below. And Leah here, one of our amazing customer support reps, will read those questions out and we can answer them while we're putting this pollinator hotel together.
Sita, we've actually got a few questions that came through yesterday. Will the native bees be attracted to this, or do you need something to entice them for them to make it their home?
Okay. You don't need to do anything to the tubes other than some of them have a little membrane of bamboo. It might be an idea to clean them out, although most pollinators are used to cleaning out a little hole in reeds or something in our environment. So there's nothing you really need to do apart from put those tubes in, put it in a area in your garden or even on the veranda of your house where it, what would be perfect is it just gets a little bit of warm, gentle sunlight at some times of the day and the pollinators will eventually find it. It can take some time and it does depend on how many pollinators there are in your area. But the idea is you're simply creating habitat for these amazing unsung heroes of our bee world.
So, yeah. And can the pollinator house be placed near an existing flow hive?
Absolutely. There's no issues between having one of these right by your flow hive. So if you've got your flow hive in your garden, you can position this right nearby, and that's okay. I've seen the European honeybee and native bees sharing the same flowers. And you'll actually see one of the pieces of footage I shot in that pollinator video was of a water lily with European honeybees and the native TC bees coming to collect the pollen and nectar. So yeah, no issues. You can just put them side by side in your garden. So next goes on the ridge cap, like so. Just line it up so that the screw holes are midway. So that goes right on top of the gabled roof. And we push the screw down into the wood and turn it around like so. And in we go.
Cedar Kate's asking, would carpenter bees be attracted to this?
Carpenter bees. Now, as with all things bees, there's often local knowledge. So in your area, you'll need to find out what type of bees you have. And I do believe carpenter bees will nest in tubes like this, but best to check. There's a wealth of information online, a lot of people doing great work in the pollinator space. There's some links on our website to organisations that will have answers for you. We've got quite a lot of different species. If you have a look at this poster on the wall here, this is some of the ones that are around in this area. We've got the fire-tailed resin bee. Some of the bee species won't nest in a house like this, like the blue banded bee here that actually likes holes in mud. So there's a lot more you can easily do to help pollination in your garden by creating whole pollinator zones. And you might get some ideas from the little video. If you haven't seen the video already, it's on our Facebook page, also on the YouTube channel called Flow Pollinator House. So next, we're going to put on the roof shingles. Now, a little tip, you notice I haven't quite tightened down these screws yet. So I'm going to now slide that shingle under the ridge cap.
The sound has been lost.
Oh, okay. The sound has been lost. Let us know if the sound comes back. Is the sound coming back? Please, someone give us a thumbs up.
Back.
Okay, sound's back. So you might have to come a little closer now, using the mic from the phone instead. So I'm just doing up the screw on the top here, and you can see how easy it is to put in these screws. There's no need to have a drill. Again, just stopping when the screw is flush with the top. I'll do the same thing here. If you do have any questions, put them in the comments below. There's no such thing as a silly question, so just feel free to put them in the comments and we'll keep answering while we put this house together. It's a nice thing to do with your kids. It's a little project that doesn't take very long, and you get to use this tool on the screws, and also little bees often become quite a fascination, all the insects that help pollinate our gardens and our world that we all depend on. Kids love bugs. My little boy does. We're always out looking at the different things and explaining how it works with the pollinators that have to go and get on the flowers before the fruit will come. And it's a really nice piece of education. Now, I'm just tightening down the last screw on this side of the roof. What we're going to do before we close in the other side of the roof is insert the bamboo tubes for the pollinators. Now, why I'm leaving that open is we're going to put some straw and sticks and things in the top here for some of the pollinators like to nest in more like mulch and twigs and sticks, so they can come through these holes in the side and through the holes in the front into that area, and they'll like that nice little mulchy, sticky, twiggy home. So the next thing we do is fill the house with these tubes. So these tubes come already done for you. All we're going to do is put them into the box. Now, this is a nice thing to do with your kids also, is you can just grab the tubes like so and insert them in to your pollinator house. And you can even create, you can even put extra things in there. You can get ideas online of how to further entice bee species in your area. Some bees like holes in wood, some like tubes like this. That's why we included some holes in wood. And others like holes in mud. Well, you could put mud in here also. You've got your whole garden area to play in, so you might like to do that in a separate area, making holes in mud for mud species. The idea here is just to simply support all of the little pollinators that we all depend on. And so 100% of the profits from this is going to habitat regeneration and protection to further help pollinators. So it's fantastic. We're almost sold out, only been live for a day. So that's absolutely fantastic news. And we are really proud here in the office. Everyone's buzzing today, knowing that we're helping to spread the word and help the habitat for these really important species of our bee world.
Peter.
Yep.
Leonardo's asking, will the pollinators fight each other as the holes are really close together?
That's a good question. From what I've seen, the pollinators don't fight each other, but the insect world is varied. There's 19,000 little pollinators, little native bee species, solitary bee species, that could use this. So I can't say the interactions between them will always be pleasant, but normally they will be. So you'll probably find that the bees won't mind being in such close proximity.
Great. Zalmira is asking, or is saying she has bumblebees in her garden. Will bumblebees use the pollinator house?
Okay. Bumblebees. That's a good question. You may have to do a little research to find out. I don't claim to be an expert in all types of bees. So if you can find out the answer and put it in the comments below, that would be fantastic. Bumblebees we don't have in this area. We do have them in Tasmania. I did take a video of a bumblebee weeing once in Tasmania here, which is the most southern part of Australia. And that's on our Facebook page somewhere. Slow motion bumblebee wee. Yep, that's neat. So we're just continuing to put these little tubes in, and once we've done that, we're going to put the twigs and leaves in the top section for other types of pollinators. And as you get close to the top, we're going to be just starting to jam them in there to help jam the tubes in. Now these are bamboo tubes, which are a nice preferred home for many types of pollinators. So now getting towards the top.
Cedar, this is another question from yesterday. Where do you place the pollinator house, and do you wait for solitary bees to find it, or is it necessary to source them?
Okay, so this is designed just to place in your garden as habitat. So the solitary bees from all around that are coming into your garden and checking it out will go, wow, there's some great habitat, and that will assist them to rear their young and help get more pollinators into your garden. There are some types of bees in the world, solitary bees, that you can actually buy eggs in and propagate in your garden. So that's called the mason bee, which if you're in the USA, you could look up how to help the mason bees in your garden. It's a fun thing to do, but that's usually designed with a home that you then clean out and store the eggs. I think store them in the fridge over winter, and then bring them out again in summer. This isn't designed like that. This is for the bees that are around in your neighbourhood, just to give them more habitat. So you don't need to buy in bees for this pollinator house. Quite different to the European bee, where you do need to get started with bees in your flow hive. So you just keep putting these in till it's nice and tight in the top. And you'll notice there is a few spares, which if you notice after a year or so, if the tubes are getting a little bit used to the point of needing to be replaced, keep these spares on hand. And we'll also be offering spare tubes if you, after a couple of years, you might like to replace all the tubes in your house, or you can make your own by cutting your own bamboo or reeds. Okay, we haven't got the microphone connected at the moment, so I've been asked to speak up a bit. So next goes the twigs, if we put them in the top. So you can put a combination of things like the mulch or twigs. This step you don't have to do. It's just an added thing for some of the species that like to nest in this kind of habitat. So you can just put them in the top. You can also find even pine cones and things like that. Some species, like this is the Banksia we have here in Australia. You can put some of them in. Some more mulch. And you might even like to include some twigs, which you can put in the top. Leaves can be another thing you can get. So you can put leaves in the top as well. Once you've put the stuffing in there, you can then put your shingles on this side of the roof and close that off. If you've got any questions, put them in the comments below and we will keep answering them as we finish off this pollinator house.
Amber would like to know whether the wasps will be attracted to it and will that affect the bees?
Okay, there are some species of wasps that will nest in certain sizes. Now, you'll notice that a lot of these tubes are on the small size. Wasps, there's many species of wasps as well, and some of them are actually good pollinators. I've been watching them in the garden pollinating, which is fantastic. The types of wasps that will nest in here generally aren't the aggressive type. The ones around here anyway, we get what's called the paper wasp, which makes its own almost honeycomb-like structure. And they're the ones that really are aggressive and sting you. The type that might nest in here are the ones that like to pack holes with mud, and you'll probably find they're not an issue if they move in. Now, having said that, some people have severe allergic reactions to insect bites, and knowing your first aid is a good idea. We have links on our website that can help you with that. Again, unlikely to be causing an issue with stinging types of wasps. Any more questions?
Yeah, there's one that follows on from that. Christopher's asking, will spiders want to nest in there?
Okay. Like all things in the garden, you will find spiders, you will find all sorts of insects, and they're actually quite important to the whole matrix of life we all depend on. So part of this project is actually encouraging people to put away the insecticide and start making habitat. So spiders are fascinating things to watch as well. Having said that, spiders generally like a different kind of habitat than this. So we're just about there with the last couple of screws. So it's a fun little project to put together. It goes together quite easily. As you can see, you don't need the power tools for this. It's made with upcycled offcuts. So we've collected the Flowhive offcuts and put them in the corner, and then we've decided, okay, what can we do with these? How can we use them to reduce our waste and create a new product? So this product is designed to both upcycle our waste and support the little pollinators. And also we're donating 100% of the profits from these to habitat regeneration and protection, because it's really important to protect our little unsung heroes of the bee world. Now, that's a complete pollinator house. There's still a couple of screws to put in. if you want to hang it on the wall, then you can put, we've included a screw to put into your wall. And because we don't want it to hang on an angle, we've included a little pinhole at the bottom here. So if you look at the back of this, you can see we've left a screw hanging out there at about the same level as the top. And that just means that it'll hang nice and neatly on the wall. Once you put your screw on the wall, it can hang here like so. So we'll do that now and just put this little pollinator house up on the wall here. So in the back, there's the little keyhole that the screw slides into. Once you've lined that up, it can then just sit neatly on the wall like that. And some people like to put them on the wall, other people like to put them in the garden. The idea is just simply to create more homes for the important little solitary bees and pollinators that we all completely depend on. We're almost sold out on these. We've only had them up for a day, so we're pretty excited that that's happening and we're able to donate 100% of the profits to Habitat Regeneration and Protection. Catch us same time next week. Thanks for watching.